Welcome back to the shop. Today we're working on my dad's Mercedes. This is a Mercedes ML320. It's a 2007 and it has a engine light on and it lost some power and it's been having some issues. And it has reported an engine code. And on this scanner, the Mercedes engine code says it's a 2530-4. Check the component inlet port shutoff motor signal wire interrupted. On a typical OBD scanner, it has a port module 2008, which is intake runner control circuit open bank 1. In these motors, there is a swirl flap motor. Sits down underneath the turbo and it opens and closes those swirl flaps. If you're here and you're watching this video, it's probably because you're having a similar issue or you're curious about it. Let's take a look at it. I think what the problem is probably that motor is frozen up and either the linkage is seized or the motor is bad, and we need to make sure that those ports stay open and then disable the motor or replace it, depending on what the issue is. If I really wanted to fix it, I could go in and replace actuators or anything was in there was broken. It might require up to a complete intake manifold replacement, but as long as all the linkage is in place and it's open, I can disable the motor and we might lose a little bit of efficiency on the low end, but it would be quite a bit less of a cost involved. So we're going to dig into it. Let's go. We were able to peel the fuel filter out of the way. Couple other things, just kind of pushed them out of the way, and we can see down in to where the swirl flap motor is. Let me take you off the tripod and we'll get a look at that. So right down there is a runner for the intake swirl flaps. You can see one of the connectors for the valves right there. Oh, come on, focus. There you go. And it runs along the back, and there is the connector, and there is your motor. So the intake runner on the passenger side should be towards the back. And I think that the intake runner on the driver's side is supposed to be towards the front. So if we can validate that those guys are in the space where they're supposed to be and those valves are open, then we can put a resistor mod into, where'd it go? This guy right there. That's all I'm gonna work on tonight. I've got it apart. I've got a pretty good idea what I'm looking for. I'm gonna go inside. I'm going to dig through some photos of the last time that I did this, and I'm just going to make sure that those intake runners are supposed to be all the way forward on the passenger driver's side and backwards on the passenger side. Forward, driver, backward, passenger. I think that's what it is. I got to write it down on a piece of paper so I remember, and I'll put it on the screen right now. Over here, maybe? Or over there? Over there? Over there? Somewhere like that. Put it on the screen. And then I'm going to make sure that they're in the position they're supposed to be. And then I'm going to put a resistor into that plug. And I'll show you that. It'll be a second for you. But it's going to be a couple of days or a day at least for me. So I know I said that I was going to come back to this. I don't remember where I left off the last time I started filming. But here we are. We're back. Now the next thing that I did is I went in and I checked to make sure that the swirl flaps are in the open position. So now I've been able to verify that. And just for future reference, the intake runner, which is the rail that connects the individual intake cutoff ports, I'll call it the intake runner. The intake runner on the passenger side, which is the far side over here, or the right side of the vehicle, that arm has to be to the back. And then on the driver's side, or the left side from the driver's position, from the inside, this side, the intake runner has to be to the front. So the arms on that flap have to be opposite for open position. So now that I've checked that, I'm going to install the resistor, tiny little resistor. I don't know if it's in focus or not. Yeah, all right. That's a 4.7 K ohm resistor. I'm going to put that in between the two center posts on the plug for the swirl motor. And that should trick the computer into making sure that it's not going to put this thing in limp mode when it's trying to call for the swirl flaps to close. It's just going to leave them open. It can cause some efficiency problems, and it will eventually probably have to be addressed. But for now, I want to make sure the rest of this car is functioning the way that it's supposed to before I go digging into that. To get to the swirl motor, you have to take the intake manifolds out. Much bigger job. There's plenty of other videos on YouTube on how to do this. So we're going to get to it, and we're going to clean up that plug a little bit. I'm going to put the resistor in, put it back together, and we'll give it a shot. So here's what I did. I put the resistor in there. I doubled over the wires on top of each other, and I twisted them together, and then I put a little piece of welding wire in there to keep the contacts in. So that will keep that as connected. Hopefully that will not rattle loose or anything like that. It's pretty firmly in there. If I ever need to, I can just grab these little pieces of wire with needle nose pliers and pull them out. Now I'm going to wrap that and shrink wrap it so that it stays pretty dry, and we'll go from there. So I want to shrink wrap this thing right here on the end. Problem is, it'll be open all the way through. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a piece of rubber, and I'm going to trace it out to be about the size of that. So it's about like this. So I'm going to take that guy like that. I'm going to take a piece of rubber, set it on there, and then I'll shrink wrap the whole thing. Let's cut this guy out. There we go. So, oh, that's gone. This guy will go on the end there. This guy will go right over top of that, kind of down in, and then that guy will go in there like that. And then that whole thing should shrink down right over top of it so that it seals it right up. I just set the batwing in there for now. I replugged in all the connectors. I put the fuel filter back where it's going to go. I have everything back to where it's supposed to be. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to fire it up. I'm going to clear the codes, and I'm going to see if the code for the swirl motor goes away before I shrink that shrink wrap on there. I think this is an excellent time to point out the code reader that I'm using. It's an MX808 from Autel. I got it on Amazon. I did a little video on this, so if you haven't seen it, go check out my channel. I'll try to put a link in the corner here if I get a chance. I have been very happy with it, and so far it's been doing everything I wanted it to do, and I'm really glad that I added it to my arsenal of tools. Even though it was a little expensive, I'll get over it. Anyway, I'm clearing the codes, making sure that it's good to go. I still have one from the glow plugs, but we'll deal with that on a different video, and I'm going to send you back to me back in the shop. Now that I've fired it up, I know that resistor is doing the job. I'm going to heat shrink that into place. I'm going to put everything back together. I'm going to drive it around a little bit and see what happens. Put this batwing back in here, take it for a spin, and we'll check to make sure that all the power is good and everything should be okay. Even with the glow plug that isn't quite functioning right, the car should run pretty well, especially in these temperatures. We're in a pretty warm climate right now. It's about 70 some degrees outside, car should start and run fine without all of its glow plugs. Well, that took care of that. I drove around the block. Swirl motor code is gone. I still have the glow plug code. We'll deal with that on another day. But that's it for now. Thanks for stopping out. Like, subscribe, and if you're already subscribed, don't leave. See you guys on the next one.